again. Yes, yes, hurrah, hurrah. It is lovely to see you all here this morning. My name is Sarah, and I'm going to be leading through our time together. Today is an all-age service, so everything is for everyone, and we're really glad that we are here together today. Hello to everybody watching online. It's lovely to have you, whether you're watching live on a Sunday morning or later in the week at your leisure. It's lovely to have you. And if you're on the telephone as well, it's great to have you dialing in. If you haven't been here before, if it's your first time, the toilets are around to my left and to my right, and you are especially welcome, as is everyone. So if we could just stand together, we are going to welcome Jesus and gather in this place together. And we recognize that we are all slightly different, which is a good thing. So I would like everyone to have a look around and see if they can find, you have to move, just look around. Is there someone that is a bit different from you? Might work in a different place, might be a different age, might have glasses, might not have glasses, might have a different color hair. And I'd like you to wave at them and say, yeah, we're different, and it's good to have everybody here. It's good to be together. Oh, that sounds like an advert, doesn't it? If we can have the words on the screen for our opening prayer, recognizing that we come from different backgrounds and we want to worship God together. If you'd like to say the words in yellow, and I will say, we gather together as the people of God in this place, from different backgrounds, cultures, languages, and lives, we come to worship. We bring all that we are and all that we have and offer it to God in praise. Fabulous. I'm going to hand over to Joel and the worship team.
Come, now is the time to worship. Come, now is the time to give your heart. Come, just as you are, to worship. Come, just as you are before. Confess you are God. One day every knee will bow. Still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now. Come, now is the time to worship. Come, now is the time.
Time to give.
is the time to give your heart. Come, just as you are, to worship. Come, just as you are before your God. Come, come, won't you come? Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Your power and love, sweet, bright, holy, 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 holy. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord.
Wonderful. If you'd like to take your seats, we are now coming to the part of our service that we normally call confession, which is when we say sorry for things that we have done wrong. And we're going to do that because it's really good to do that regularly, to look at our week and to recognize the things that we've picked up, the things that maybe we've done that we shouldn't have done, the things that maybe we haven't done that we did do and shouldn't, should do and didn't, and all of that stuff. It's good to just have a quick assess. And how we're going to do that today is we're going to play a game of supermarket sorry. So underneath, so those of you sitting at the back in the cafe, if you want to join in, you might want to send some of your smaller people to come hunting, because I've left some groceries that I normally would have been picking up during the week, and they are under some of your chairs. So have a look under your chairs, see if you can find any of the groceries, and bring them up to me, please. Are there some groceries? Bring them up to me. Up you come, up you come. Fabulous, stand in a line, stand in a line. Wonderful. Okay, and hold them up to people, showing them what they actually say so they can see the words on the front. Fabulous. Okay, and what brand supermarket are we at? Can you read what brand? What does it say on the little bit at the top?
Clear Spring.
No, there, on that label there. What does it say?
Sorry.
Sorry, it's all branded Sorry. Come and stand up here, Henry. We need you up here. So let's have a look and see what we've got here. These are things that we might pick up during the week. I'm using two mics. That's really silly, isn't it? Things that we might pick up during the week and actually weigh us down. Are they a bit heavy? Are those things a bit heavy? If you had a lot of them in a bag, would it be heavy? It would. So what have we got here? Do you know what that word says on there, Henry? Hang a minute, wait for it. Have I turned it on? I've turned it off. I've turned it on. What's it say?
Flour.
It does say flour. Well, actually, it says flour on the... Yeah, do you know, I think you've done really well guessing that it says flour and it starts with F, but it's a very long word and it says frustrated. Can you say frustrated?
Frustrated.
Absolutely. Super. Well done, Henry. That is great. And it's not any frustrated. It's Marks and Spencer's frustrated. There we go. What does yours say?
Rude.
What does yours say?
Selfish.
Fighting.
Little lies,
not big lies, little lies. We didn't have a big lies, but you know, sometimes it's easier to realise that we've told little lies. What does yours say?
Impatient.
Blamed others.
Argued.
Unkind.
And there's lots of little things that we could do throughout the week that get in the way and weigh us down. I bought some bags, but I thought, actually, do you know what? I don't think they'll all fit in one bag because they're so heavy. So why don't we line them up here on the altar? Let's just make a little bit of space. Those candles don't move. There we go. If you'd like to come and pop your stuff on the altar, and we will then pray to say sorry to God. Thank you very much. If you want to go and sit down once you've put your stuff up here, not too near the candles. Thank you. Lovely. Pop them here. Lovely. There's lots of things that can weigh... Oh, my, you've got the heaviest one, Henry. That was the heaviest. There's lots of things that can weigh us down during the week, but it's really good to bring them to God and to say sorry. So if we can have the words on the screen. If we'd like to stand up to say this together, if you want to stand up... And recognizing all these little things that we could be carrying around, things that we've said and done or haven't said and done, let's bring it to God. There are things that we are sorry that we did because they are wrong. There are other things we did not do which we know we should have done. Please forgive our mistakes and help us not to make them again. And we know that we can thank Jesus. We can thank you for life, for sending Jesus into the world so that we can enjoy it even more. We are grateful to you for taking care of us from day to day. Please accept our thanks and help us never to take your love for granted. Amen. Thank you, Joel.
From the moment that I wake up.
the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so
reminded of God's faithfulness, isn't it, and his goodness. Super, if you'd like to take your seats, Chris is going to do something very important, and he's going to read some banns of marriage.
Yes, get these right. So I published the banns of marriage between Jake Whalen and Karina Morganroth. These are for the first time of asking. If any of you know any reason in law why these persons may not marry each other, you are to declare it now. I always love that bit of silence. And also for Daniel Valentin Carballo and Valerie Alice Marie Lipiat, these are for the third time of asking. If any of you know any reason in law why these persons may not marry each other, you are to declare it now. Second bit of good silence. Well, let's pray for the couples as they prepare for their wedding days. God, we thank you for these couples, for their impending wedding days. We pray that they have wonderful wedding days, that you are present in them and with them. And we pray that you are with them in their married lives together and in all the years to come. Amen.
Amen. Fantastic. Thank you so much, Chris. And just as the notices are coming up on the screen, one thing that's not on the notices, but I would love to tell you about because I've got a bit of a vested interest, is next Saturday at 10 o'clock, our Eco Garden Workshop start again. So we would, that's it, we're like a woo-hey. We would love you to come. I will bring some buns. So bring a water bottle. You might need to bring some sunscreen because I've got lots of faith. And we're going to be out for the first session this spring. We're going to see what can be harvested. We've got some mooli, which is like a Japanese radish that's ready to go. And we'll see what other things can be harvested. And we'll sow some seeds for this coming season. So do join us. And it's about 2 hours, 10 till 12. Then the rest of the stuff on the screen that is happening this week. We've got so much stuff. We've got a great church. Lots of things happening. Today we've got our evening service here at 6:30. And Verity's preaching. It's going to be a good one. Wednesday, Holy Communion at 10, as usual. Thursday evening, we've got Silent Sanctuary here at 7:30. Great opportunity just to carve an hour and just sit in the presence of God, allowing him to speak to us and just to reconnect, charge our batteries and to hear from him. Spy Cafe is open after Easter break, so Tuesday to Saturday, from 8:30 to 3:30. Saturday's a little bit later, which I think is always a good thing. And then we've got the women's event on the 27th of April. If you've had the parish email, you'll know there's details of that there. If you don't get the parish email, go to the welcome desk at the back after the service whilst we're having coffee. Sign up the parish email. You can get more information there. Alpha starts. We've been talking about Alpha over the Easter season. If you haven't done Alpha, do think about it. It's a great opportunity. Monday evenings, some snacks, a videos, some chat, and an opportunity to find out what we believe as Christians. So do consider Alpha if you haven't done that before. Every Saturday in May, we've got nature walks. I can't remember the title of the campaign that we're doing it with, but it's about getting out in nature, which is a good thing. And we've got fun walks for the whole family with a different theme each week. We meet here at Spire at 10, and then walking up to Boston Manor Park, and there's a cafe there. You can have a cafe before you go, and a cafe when you get there, here, there, everywhere a cafe. Very important meeting, the APC, an annual parish or parochial church or something meeting. Yes, it's important. It's like an AGM, and it's after the service here on Sunday the 12th of May. Please try to be around for that. And then we've got baptisms on the 19th of May. It's all happening. It's all good. It's really exciting. Thank you for your patience while you've sat there through all of that exciting stuff. You can now stand up again. Oh, stand up, sit down, do the hokey-cokey. We are going to do the peace. And we are going to have an opportunity to bless each other and shake hands and just share this peace that we have from God with each other. So the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let's offer one another a sign of peace. Your seats. You can say hello to people over coffee afterwards. Come back. We are going to declare our faith. We're going to use the words, we call it a creed, a declaration of faith, and we've got a great one here that's easy for us all to join in. Telling God, telling each other what we believe as Christians. So the words are on the screen. Let's join in together. With all Christians everywhere, we believe in one God who made everything. The Father sent his Son, Jesus, to die on the cross. Jesus rose again as Lord of all, that we might live together with forever together with him, forever together. God sent his Holy Spirit to live in us, that we might grow more like Jesus. Amen. Fabulous. If you'd like to sit down, and I'm going to invite Reuben and Russell to come and give us our readings, and then Denise is going to be speaking to us.
The first reading is from Luke 24, verse 13 to 34. Oh, yeah. Now, that same day, two of them were going to a village called Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem. They were talking with each other about everything that had happened. As they talked and discussed these things to each other, Jesus himself came up and walked along with them, but they were kept from recognizing him. He asked them, "What are you discussing together as you walk along?" They stood still, their faces downcast. One of them, named Cleopas, asked him, "Are you the only one visiting Jerusalem who does not know the things that have happened there in these days?" "What things?" he asked. "About Jesus of Nazareth," they replied. "He was a prophet, powerful in word and deed before God and all the people. The chief priests and our rulers handed them over to be sentenced to death, and they crucified him. But we had hoped that he was the one who was going to redeem Israel. And what is more, it is the third day since all this took place. In addition, some of our women amazed us. They went to the tomb early this morning, but didn't find his body. They came and told us that they had seen a vision of angels who said he was alive. Then some of our companions went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said, but they did not see Jesus. He said to them, "How foolish you are, and how slow to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Did not the Messiah have to suffer these things and then enter his glory?" And the beginning with the Moses and all the prophets, he explained to them what was said in all the scriptures concerning himself. As they approached the village to which they were going, Jesus continued on as if he were going further. But they urged him strongly, "Stay with us, for it is nearly evening. The day is almost over." So he went in to stay with them. When he was at the table with them, he took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to them, saying, Then their eyes were opened and they recognized him, and he disappeared from their sight. They asked each other, "Were not our hearts burning within us while he talked with us on the road and opened the scriptures to us?" They got up and returned at once to Jerusalem. They were found to at the 11 and those with them assembled together and saying, "It is true, the Lord has risen and has appeared to Simon."
The second reading is taken from Acts chapter 1, verses 1 to 3. In my former book, Theophilus, I wrote about all that Jesus began to do and to teach until the day he was taken up to heaven. After giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles he had chosen, after his suffering, he presented himself to them and gave many convincing proof that he was alive. He appeared to them over a period of 40 days and spoke about the kingdom of God. Here ends the reading.
Thank you, Russell and Reuben. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, please take the words that I've prepared and reach into our hearts and minds. Help us be aware of your presence with us, Jesus, and receive the power of the Holy Spirit to change our lives. Amen. Now, we've all experienced those times when we've had a bitter blow, unexpected. Our hopes and dreams have been dashed to pieces. And that's exactly what Cleopas and his friend felt as they walked from Jerusalem. It's only been 3 days, it's a Sunday afternoon, and their Lord and Saviour, the person they thought who was going to be the Messiah, the one that was going to redeem Israel, he's gone. And even though they've heard in the morning, the women have told them this amazing tale of Jesus being risen, they can't believe it. It's beyond their comprehension. So when a chap joins them and walks along the road and says, "What's wrong?" they tell him, because they can't see God's hand at work. They can't see the big picture. They can't comprehend the scriptures. And even though Jesus has told them in advance what's going to happen, they didn't get it. They don't see God's big plan of salvation, forgiveness, redemption. It's oblivious to them. And sometimes we're not good at seeing the big picture either. Sometimes we miss the point, don't we? And yet God is always there, always working for the benefit. Because our hopes and dreams aren't built on sort of nothing. Our hope is built on the fact that God is able. God raised Jesus from the dead. Everything is possible for God. But we're a bit impatient and we want a quick fix and we don't notice how God's always working for the best. We're not good at recognising what's going on, are we? Just think, there's times when you've been walking along the road and a car's gone beep, 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 and somebody's waved, and then they're gone, and you're thinking, who was that? Or you're in the supermarket, and you spot somebody and you think, oh, they look familiar, but I can't work out why I know them. But you don't go up to them because you don't want to be embarrassed, do you? Or you're at a party and you see somebody and you think, oh, we've met before, but where was it? And it's only once you get talking to them you realise, oh, it was in the swimming class. Oh, you look so different with clothes on. There's all those cases where we don't actually recognise what's going on. And Jesus appears to Cleopas and his friend, but they're not expecting him. He's dead. So they don't get it. They don't realise that it's Jesus because they just aren't expecting to notice him and see him there. So we're going to play a bit of a game. So I'm going to get Tippy and Luke to come up, who are my guinea pigs. And I have some blindfolds ready for them. Oh, well, you can wear the face mask one, which doesn't muck up your hair. Just put it over your eyes and round your ears. Luke, that's a far more comprehensive one for you. And once they've got their blindfolds on, I need four volunteers who don't mind doing a little bit of dressing up and acting. Can I have four volunteers? Get it on, Luke. Get it on. Come on, come on. Over your eyes, Tippy.
Sorry, now. Okay, sorry. My bad.
Right. Two more volunteers. Come on, two more. They can be grown-up ones. Yep. Come on, Mace. Come on. Almost blew it. Now, I'm going to give you some disguises. Hold on. I think, would you wear that on your... On your nose. Hopefully these will stick. Just goes right over the top. Right. And we're going to pull that right down there. Right. Now, these disguised people, you can wrap it around yourself. And what I want you to do, so Tippy and Luke are going to be listening, and you have to say, guess who, in a funny voice, so they can't recognise you.
Do we get to take off the
back? No. So you say, guess who? Luke, were you listening?
Was it not Max?
Was it Max? I don't know, we'll see. We'll see in a minute.
Is that you? Who's that?
That's Denise. Do you want to say guess who?
Guess who?
Go on, Luke, can you guess?
Go again.
Say it again.
Guess who?
What? I don't know.
Now you say guess who?
Guess who?
Tippy, any ideas?
All the people in this whole church family?
Yeah.
All right, well.
Try again.
I'm starting to think it might be
Macy. Mm. What do you think, Luke? Any ideas?
I've got no idea.
Guess who?
One more.
Guess who?
That was definitely.
Right, now you can take your blindfolds off and see if you're any better at recognising people.
Hang on, we only had three. Did anyone not? Why did
this game, like they did get some of them right, but the idea of the game is that actually it's really hard sometimes to recognise people when they're in disguise, when they're using a different voice, when they look a bit different, when you're not necessarily expecting to see them. Right, thank you. A round of applause to our volunteers. Thank you for wearing beards and moustaches. It was difficult. They got some right. But that's how it was when Cleopas and his friend had Jesus join them. They thought he was dead. And it's beyond their expectation that he'd be walking down the road. And so Jesus isn't recognised. And Jesus then goes on to explain how those old scriptures point forward to the Christ, who is actually their beloved Messiah. And Jesus is repeatedly not recognised. He's not recognised by Mary in the garden. He's not recognised by Cleopas and the friend. He's not recognised by the disciples in the fishing boat. So even though the risen Jesus isn't easily recognised and doesn't seem limited by time and space because, like, he can appear and disappear at will, he can reveal himself in ways that are just right for that person. So for Cleopas on the road to Emmaus, it's when Jesus breaks the bread during the meal and the penny drops and Cleopas thinks, that's Jesus. For Mary in the garden, it's when the gardener calls her by name and says, Mary. And it really touches her and she knows it's her Lord. For the two fishermen, for Peter and John and the others, they're out rowing their boat, not catching any fish. It's a bit later on in the story. And then all of a sudden, a stranger on the shore says, try over there on that right side of the boat. And they pull in this huge haul of fish. And it's that that makes Peter and John think, it's our Lord. And they rush to see him. So Jesus knows how to re-engage with us, how to reveal himself. And for Cleopas, it restored all of his hopes and expectations. And just like Jesus knew how to reveal himself in those situations which I've just spoken about, he knows how to reveal himself to each one of us. And wouldn't it be good if we started to recognize that Jesus walks with us on our daily journey? He's there with us at all times and in all places. So we need to occasionally just stop, pause, and invite Jesus to reveal himself. And then give ourselves a chance to notice his presence with us. Sometimes we need to get rid of all those distractions and have stillness and quiet. And invite Jesus to draw close. And he knows exactly how to reveal himself. We're all different, aren't we? We come from different backgrounds, we like different things, we all think differently. And so some of us might see pictures. Some of us might feel his love or sense his light or his glory or sense a touch. Or others will suddenly find a Bible verse is going round and round their mind. Or perhaps a song lyric, a worship song lyric springs up and is like an earbud inside. There's no right and wrong way. And Jesus knows how to engage with us. Even when we're reluctant to engage, he understands and he wants to reveal his heart to us. He wants to know when we're feeling, you know, sad and let down by life. So just like he explains the scriptures to Cleopas and the friend, how can we invite Jesus to unlock the scriptures for us when we're struggling to understand? And the answer's simple. We just ask him. We invite the Holy Spirit to guide us. And if we start to notice Jesus more and more in our daily walk, we start to hear those instructions, just like he gave instructions to his disciples. Now, if that's the case, surely we're going to go wrong less in life. We're going to know what to do. We're going to have confidence and not be fearful. So even when our life is full of potholes and our journey is tough, God sustains our hope because Jesus is alive. And he can join us wherever and whenever we want him to. And that means that we can hold on to hope and we can start to trust that God's big picture is working its way out for the best. And when we feel that our hope is struggling, we can come and ask God to open the eyes of our hearts, to notice where he's at work, to notice where there's little signs of the kingdom of God springing up. And that helps us hold on to joy despite what's going on around us. Jesus is alive and he's bringing his kingdom about in this fallen world. So I want us to practice being aware of his presence. And we might want to take things to Jesus. We might want to ask him questions. But he knows how to interact with us. He knows how to communicate with us. Earlier we sung, "Open the eyes of our heart, Lord. We want to see you." Let's take that seriously. So I'm going to invite you to stand and we're just going to pray and invite Jesus to draw close. Heavenly Father, you are the good, good God that has an amazing plan, a plan for redemption, a plan for forgiveness, a plan for life and hope. And Jesus, you're the answer to that plan. And you are alive. You are here now. You are with each and every one of us. So Jesus, we invite you, come and reveal more of your presence to us right now. Come, Lord Jesus. I'm going to encourage you to invite him to draw close. Invite him to reveal himself to you in a new way for this morning. And as you reach out in your mind's eye to find that divine presence, bring yourself to him as you are. You can talk to him where you're about things where your hopes have felt dashed. Or perhaps when you're struggling with something. And then give him a chance to respond to you. Holy Spirit, we ask that you will open the eyes of our hearts and be at work with your amazing power. Amen.
ever sing, your presence is heaven to me. Your presence is heaven to me. Yes, your presence is heaven to me. Yes, your presence is heaven to me. Send your presence, your presence is heaven to me. Who is like you, Lord, in all the earth? Matchless love and beauty, endless worth. Nothing in this world can satisfy. Jesus, you're the cup that won't run dry. It's your presence is heaven to me. Is heaven to me. Yes, your presence is heaven to me. Your presence is heaven to me. Treasure of my heart and of my soul. In my weakness, you are merciful. Redeemer of my past and present wrongs. Holder of my future days to
heaven. Thank you.
Into a time of prayer now, but instead of sitting, we're going to move, because Denise and has been helping us think, and we've been thinking about God with us in our weeks. And what I thought we could do is have a bit of a walk through our weeks while we're still here in the building. So some of you will have noticed is I've laid out a little trail of arrows that you can follow. It's not new COVID precautions. We're way past that, thank goodness. But you can follow around the building. And maybe as you're going, you might want to pray about things you've got coming up in your week. And you might want to go by yourself or with some of the people you're with. And along the way, you'll find a couple of points where Carol has helped us prepare some pictures and things that we might want to pray about. But what we'll do now is just go out, follow the path around, pray about our weeks, pray about some of the prayer points that you can find, and then we'll come back and pray the Lord's Prayer together when we finish. So the guy's going to put some music on for us in a second, so why don't we start following the arrows wherever you are as we pray together. going to say the Lord's Prayer together as we bring our time of prayer to a close. Do finish up where you are at your own pace. But for those of us who are finished, let's say the Lord's Prayer together and then we'll sing our final hymn. So as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Well, let's sing our final song together.
Of wrath are stored. He has lit the faithful lightning of his terrible swift sword. His truth is marching on. He has sounded forth the trumpet that shall never go retreat. He is sifting out the hearts of all before his judgment seat.
Us to journey with him. And we're about to have the words up for the closing blessing. Please do stay for coffee, chat to people, visit the welcome table if you've not been before. And let us be blessed this week. May God, who walks with us as we journey with him, help us to know his presence with us wherever we are and whatever we are doing this week. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst us and remain with us always. Amen. And with the risen of life, with Christ within, with the risen life of Christ within, I so need glasses that work this way. With the risen life of Christ within, you go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Eyes of my heart, Lord, open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you.
Holy, holy, I want to see you.